population interaction. If you turn the page, soil pressure page, if you turn, you will see this population interaction. That is our topic today. Very nice topic. So many 2 marks questions are there. Definitely you will get 2 marks questions from this under this heading. Definitely. 1 2 marks question is there in this ecology. 8 plus 2 marks. 8 marks question 1, 2 marks question only 1. But from this chances are more. Recent paper, ultraviolet rays advantages given, benefits of UV rays, that is given from light. And here also such a important topic, population interaction. So here, no species live in isolation. This is the important class we have to take into consideration regarding interaction. Then there is no meaning of interaction if they are isolated. Isolated means the species living alone. No species can live alone. That is the meaning of that. No species live in isolation in the world over, including humans. Remember this thing. Even plants also. See, for example, you take the plants. Because these are sedentary forms, fixed to the substratum. They may not move from one place to another place. They cannot also. They are non-motile organisms. But these plants also depend on microbes. Microbes means especially bacteria and fungi. For what? Depend on microbes. For decomposition activity. Microbes are the decomposers, you know. So plants depend on, plants means producers, depend on decomposers. The microbes, commonly known as decomposers. Technical name of decomposers is microbes. When there is no decomposition activity, the dead bodies will be formed into heaps, you know. Kuppala kuppalaga padipothayi shavalu, shavala dibbala ipothayi. Heaps of dead bodies accumulated on the surface of the earth. That drawback arises. So that's why due to decomposition activity of bacteria, the soil formation occurs. When the soil formation occurs, the nutrients are also added by decomposing activity, minerals and mineral nutrients. They are the food for the plants. So that's why plants depend on microbes. These two interact with each other. That is best example. And also plants depend on animals, plants and microbes interaction. This is, for example, plants and animals interact together. For what purpose? Plants depend on animals for pollination. Animal agents, animals mainly agents of pollination. You can also write that in the bracket. Agents of pollination. Without animals, pollination is not possible. Without pollination, the seed formation, fruit formation, pod formation, fruit formation, seed formation, never there. Then the plant's life activity is totally stopped, and the continuity of life for plants is also stopped. That's why it depend on animals for pollination, agents of pollination. This is also another combination. This is for decomposition activity, they are depending on microbes. And this is for pollination, agents of pollination. Birds, pollination by birds, ornithophily. Pollination by insects, entomophily. Pollination by snails, malacophily. Pollination by snakes, ophiophily or serpentophily. Pollination by wind, anemophily. Like that, there are so many insects entomophily. Satvika? Satvika? Good morning, Satvika. हेलो ओके ओके सो प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स अनदर कॉम्बिनेशन इवन ह्यूमंस आल्सो कैन नॉट लिव इंडिपेंडेंटली सो एवरी स्पीसीज ऑफ एनिमल्स मस्ट इंटरैक्ट विद अदर स्पीसीज टू लीड देयर लाइफ मस्ट इंटरैक्ट विद अदर स्पीसीज टू लीड ए सक्सेसफुल लाइफ कॉल्ड इंटर स्पेसिफिक इंटरैक्शन इंटर मीन्स इन बिटवीन स्पेसिफिक मीन्स स्पीसीज इंटर स्पेसिफिक इंटरैक्शन दिस इज द मेन एम ऑफ पॉपुलेशन इंटरैक्शन इंटर स्पेसिफिक इंटरैक्शन इंटरैक्शन बिटवीन डिफरेंट स्पीसीज दैट इज कॉल्ड इंटर स्पेसिफिक इंटरैक्शन दिस इंटर स्पेसिफिक इंटरैक्शन कैन बी डिवाइडेड इंटू सिक्स टाइप्स दे आर डिवाइडेड इंटू सिक्स टाइप्स into mainly three types to six types mainly with benefit or loss with benefit or loss or no benefit no loss no benefit no loss So accordingly it is divided into six types. If they are beneficial, for example, interaction is beneficial, suppose. Interaction is beneficial. From both the sides, two species living together, both are getting benefit. Interaction is beneficial, the sign used is plus if the interaction is loss one will get benefit another will get loss interaction is detrimental like that the term used that is beneficial opposite word is detrimental detrimental means harmful if you want you can write down in the bracket harmful then the sign used is minus symbol is used if the interaction is suppose neutral means no benefit or no loss interaction is neutral the symbol is zero no benefit or no loss so these plus minus and zero symbols are used for these interactions so in the table is also given blue background table is there very important for matching type questions in the NEET exam MCET exam for all examinations very 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 important for example that is given here if the species are getting mutually benefit reciprocal benefit both the species living together get benefit with each other so mutualism means beneficial to both here two species are taken into consideration one is host another one is dependent so beneficial to both Hence, symbols are used. First species plus second species also plus plus comma plus symbol is both are beneficial. For beneficial, this sign is used. Already I told you. And then In competition, reverse is the case, opposite of mutualism. Both may be both incur loss. Both incur loss. Loss means detrimental, means minus and minus symbols are used for the competition. In a competition, for example, for a piece of flesh, just simply throw a piece of flesh, meat flesh. This side dog is coming and that side cat is coming to get that flesh. So who will be successful? They will get it. So cat may be successful in getting that piece of flesh. Even dog may be successful. Both also fight for each other for that piece of flesh. So loss is not in only on one side. It may be on both the sides. So that's why minus and minus used for the symbol. Competition. Competition, competing for a piece of flesh. Carnivores especially, not only dogs and cats. For example, I am giving dogs and cats, all carnivores. And then, next association is predation. Predation means one will get benefit. Will get benefit, the other will get loss. Definitions carefully remember. The other will get loss. Other will get loss. So that is plus, comma, minus. Symbols are used for the association. The same symbols are used for parasitism also. Parasitism is a fourth association. Mutualism, competition, predation, parasitism. One will get benefit here also. Parasite will get benefit, host will get loss. Same definition. The other will get loss. So plus minus, again plus minus, predation and parasitism same. And here commensalism, one will get benefit, another will get neither loss or not benefit. One gets benefit, the other gets. Neither benefit nor loss. Nor loss. So, plus zero symbols are used. This is fifth association. Fifth symbiotic association. This is called symbiosis. Symbiosis means living together. The term is used for this association and interaction. And lastly, emensalism. Minus zero. Emensalism examples are very rare. Toxocora is an emptoid parasite living in the goats. That is example, emensalism. Emensalism means, of course not necessary, you need not remember that example also. Emensalism, one gets loss and other is not affected. The other one is not affected. That is the definition. Not affected. Carefully remember this definition. So symbol used is minus and zero. Minus and zero. So like this, the questions are asking, you know, plus plus is what kind of symbiotic association? Mutualism. Minus minus, what kind of symbiotic association? Like that. So all these interspecific associations are, the beautiful term is there for this, symbiosis. Symbiosis is a, symbiosis means, bio means living. Sim means together, living together, two species living together. In that living association, one may get benefit or one may get loss, or neither benefit nor loss, accordingly those. So in this symbiosis, what is the this term, you know, plus plus indicates like that, minus minus indicates, you answer these questions, plus minus indicates, and plus minus also indicates, and plus zero indicates, and lastly minus zero indicates. So you just answer plus plus mutualism. Try to cultivate these things, competition. This is matching type question. This side, like these symbols are given. This side, these are given. You must match with this. So then predation, parasitism. Parasitism. This is column one, this is column two. For that purpose only, I have brought over to this space all those things. And this is commensalism, lastly amensalism. Amensalism definition carefully remember. Remaining definitions you can easily remember. One is getting loss, another one is affected, not affected. Not affected, that term is used. So amensalism, last one. For example, reservoir host. Reservoir host also, the host is affected, loss, but for the infective stage, there is no loss, not affected for carrying purpose. Toxocora, nematode parasite, live in the gut of goats, that is also. So anyhow, these are the symbols, six, you know, six associations, mutualism, competition, predation, parasitism, commensalism and amensalism. Now today, let us take the, according to book, version of the book, we can discuss about the competition given a predation. Predation. Predation, let us discuss. Put a heading, predation. From this also you will get questions. Just now I told you, the what is the predation definition? Association between predator and prey. Predator means the eater, eating of other organisms is called predation. That animal is predator. So between predator and prey, association between predator and prey is called predation. Like this, the massy paragraph, we should be split up into points like this. So introduction only, we got 20 points. See this, this is only up to 20 introduction, these are all. Okay. Association between predator and prey is called the predation. So in this predation, this relationship is also called predator-prey relationship. Predator hyphen prey relationship. That is there. Predators never eat all the preys available. For example, you take lion. Lion, when it is hungry, then only it go for hunting on deers or zebras or some other herbivores. So there the lion is a predator and any herbivore is a prey. So that's why all preys will not be destroyed by the predators. If the prey became extinct, predator also became extinct. So to maintain the ecological balance, otherwise, suppose for example, predators, carnivores are the best predators for the herbivores. That also you can write here. carnivores are best predators for herbivores. Predators of herbivores. Herbivores, so many: deers, zebras, cattle, sheep, goat. Everything come under the herbivores. Generalized, we have generalized here. Instead of specifying deer, goat, or something like that. పెద్దమైంది చల్లగా ఉంది ఎప్పుడు సో కార్నివోర్స్ ఆర్ ప్రిడేటర్స్ ఆఫ్ హెర్బివోర్స్ అండ్ యునో ప్లాంట్స్ ఆర్ సెడెంటరీ What are the predators of plants? Plant eaters are herbivores. So, herbivores are predators of producers. Predators of producers. Like that you can go these associations, number of associations are there. Producers means plants. So plant predators are always herbivores. They are very powerful predators than carnivores, you know. Why? Because they are grazing and browsing, both undergone by herbivores. Grazing means grass eaters. Eating of grass is called grazing. You remember this, these two points differences. Browsing means eating of leaves. For example, goats. Goats never eat grass. Goats always get the Azadirachta indica, neem tree, you know, neem tree leaves. So that's why they eat leaves. All leaf eaters are browsers, all grass eaters are grazers. So that's why herbivores are predators of producers. The total grassland ecosystem, because herbivores are in huge crowds, they are in the massy number, herds, you can see cattle, you can see herd, goats, you can see herd, deers, you can see herd in the forest, zebras also you can see in a large groups, herds, they're all herds, manda antaman, mandala mandala ga vachestai. So that's why best predators of plants are the herbivores. Do you think that seed eaters are not predators? Yes, seed eaters also predators. For example, sparrow. Sparrow is a seed predator. So, seed predators are technically named as granivores. They are technically named as granivores because they eat on seeds. Actually, sparrows are omnivores. They eat insects also. Both. So, mainly seed predators. గింజలు ఎక్కడ దొరికితే అక్కడ తినేస్తాయి, చిన్న చిన్న గింజలు అని. సో స్పారో సీడ్ ప్రిడేటర్స్, మెయిన్ స్వీట్ ప్రిడేటర్స్ ఆర్ స్పారోస్. చిన్నవి కనబడవు కానీ బ్రహ్మాండంగా తింటాయి. సో గ్రానివోర్స్, సీడ్ ప్రిడేటర్స్ ఆర్ టెక్నికలీ నేమ్డ్ యాజ్ గ్రానివోర్స్. ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ ఇన్ ది బుక్ ఇట్ ఈస్ గివెన్. సో వీఆర్ డిస్కసింగ్ ద ఇంట్రడక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ప్రిడేషన్ టాపిక్, ఇంట్రడక్షన్. అండ్ ప్రిడేటర్స్ ఆర్ కన్జ్యూట్స్ ఆఫ్ ట్రాఫిక్ ఫుడ్ చైన్స్. కన్జ్యూట్స్ ఆఫ్ predators are conduits that is used, means energy transfer occurs through predators. So herbivores are the predators of plants, means the energy trapped by plants from the sun is trapped by herbivores, which in turn trapped by herbivores. Predators, what are they? Carnivores. Like that it is going on in the trophic levels, the food chain. So predators are conduits, means pipelines, meaning if you want, how the through pipelines the fuel is transferring, we are transferring energy fuels are there, so many are there. Our gas also, in our Visakhapatnam and Andhra Pradesh, that system is not there. If you go to Maharashtra, Mumbai, gas is supplied to all domestic purpose through pipelines, Mumbai, through pipelines only. So that's why gas is a most important energy source for the cooking items. So that's why predators are the conduits, means pipelines, conduits of energy transfer. You mentioned this, but for what they are there for energy transfer from one traffic level to another traffic level. This should be completed now. One traffic level to another traffic level. Okay, that is. This is most important line. Remember, is there in the NCRT also? As it is, population interaction, as it is given in the NCRT also. So that's why carefully read out this population interaction, because it is as it is in the NCRT book also. The NCRT book lastly given, population organisms and population heading, in which it is lastly given. That is. So predators are conduits of energy transfer. Conduits means pipelines from one traffic level to another traffic level in a food chain. That also you can add in a food chain. Food chain contains how many traffic levels? Minimum 3, maximum 5. The bottom traffic level is producers, plants. Then first consumers, herbivores. Then second consumers, first carnivores. Then third consumers, second carnivores. Then climax carnivores, predators. So everyone is a predator of one traffic level in a food chain. Herbivores are the predators of plants. First carnivores are the predators of herbivores. Second carnivores are the predators of first carnivores. And predators are the climax carnivores are the predators for the all till herbivores. So that's why these are the conduits or pipelines. This is introduction. Now this chapter can be discussed under the those headings, you know. What are they? Let us see. First, predators are in biological control. Predators are in biological, or simply you need not write down the verb are, predators in biological control. Like that you can keep heading. How it is, you know, this first heading. Example is Australian grassland ecosystem. Barren land, a range land is there in the Australia. Australian grassland ecosystem is introduced by Pyrrhicactus. Introduced, pear means pear shape, berry pandu, pear fruit. Like that it is. Introduced by the Pyrrhicactus. Cactus is a desert plant, xerophyte. So it has an ability to spread hectares of land, barren land, because in Australia grassland ecosystem is, plenty of grassland ecosystem is there. It was introduced. Now it has been spread like anything. So to control the cactus, what they did, you know, so that is the most important point. To control the cacti, cacti plural, cactus singular, they introduced the moths. The predators of cacti is moth. Introduced to control the, what? Spread of cactus. Of cacti. Like that, cacti population is controlled by the introduction of this moth. Moth is a predator of cacti. What is the predator of cacti? That is asked. Moth seed predators are sparrows. Plant predators are herbivores. Like that, the questions are there. So that's why everything is split in point wise. Now, let us take the next predatory control. Predators are in species diversity. In American Rocky Tide Coast, predators in species diversity. This is the heading. This was asked once. Even for biological control, you can also give examples. And the agricultural pests are controlled by introducing some insects, you know. Agricultural pests are also controlled. That is also come under the biological control. agricultural pests, you know, paddy fields, there are so many pests, mosquito. This they suck the cell sap. Like that, the plant yield also is going to be reduced. To control that, the pest control agents are used instead of chemicals. That also play a vital role in the control of the pests for the agricultural purpose. That is also biological control. So, like that, predators in species diversity, in this, the American rocky tidal coast that is there, American rocky tidal coast, Pacific coast, in this Pacific coast, rocky area, rocky shore, that is, in the rocky tides, this Pisaster lived. Pisaster, scientific name, common name is starfish. It is living there. But there is one experiment conducted. If we remove this starfish, is the best predator in that American rocky tidal coast, Pacific coast. So if you remove this Pisaster starfish from that coast experimentally, so experimental removal of starfish, like that you say, you begin the sentence with this experimental removal of starfish. What happens, you know, the nearly 10 species of invertebrates became extinct. So this line meaning nobody could understand so far. Even majority NEET students also, they could not understand why they, because faculty must tell them. In all NEET long-term coaching centers, even long-term candidate, if anybody you come across with that, those students, he asked this experimental removal of starfish in the American tidal coast, Pacific coast. 10 species of invertebrates became extinct. Why? That is the reason. Even in the book also not clearly given. Simple ganestad ante. Became extinct. Not 10 species, more than that also. You can estimate, you can imagine. So, this starfish, if it is removed, Pisaster, what is that by name? It is Pisaster. Scientific name, starfish. Generally, our starfish in Echinoderma already told you, Asterias. Asterias, Pentaceras, Astropecten. These are the, generally we come across with those starfishes, but this is found in the American Pacific coast. Hence, it is Pisaster. So, this Pisaster, for example, it is removed experimentally, for example. 10 species of invertebrates became extinct. Why, you know? This Pisaster starfish eats the predators of these 10 species of invertebrates. And that is interspecific competition. By the removal of this, they have become extinct because the 10 species predators, 10 species of invertebrate, predators of 10 species of invertebrates are survived because of the removal of starfish. That it is. So you should note down this point. Became extinct because, reason you write down. Because the predators of the above 10 species, you write down there, even if you are observing textbook, at that white page border is there, you write down this point, so that you can, otherwise it will be lost in the memory. So because the predators of 10 species of invertebrates survived, due to removal of this starfish. That is the reason. Thus, predators are species diversity. See how it is. And next heading is, predators are prudential. Tomorrow we can see that. predators are prudential, means practical. Under these three headings are there, subheadings are there. Predators are prudential, means practical. Of course, this should be gone very slowly. That's why, of course, we can continue, but it should be gone very slowly. So that's why I wanted to stop. Tomorrow, this page I can save, and tomorrow we can continue. Okay? Predators are prudential, third heading. This is the last heading under the predation. In this, three subheadings are there. Three subheadings are there, you know. Predators. Prey, avoid predators. Prey, become distasteful to predators. Distasteful to predators. And defense mechanisms in plants. These three headings tomorrow we can see. Defense mechanisms in plants. They also save the plants. Otherwise, plants are non-motile. They cannot escape from the predator. That's why, that is the problem. So, okay, tomorrow you can see, I can end the class.